Hello everybody, welcome to our new video. Today we're going to show you how to make your 5G run a little bit faster than what you have now. Since 5G came out in Johannesburg, and we tested it in different places. Because the first one which they brought, the modem which was in the one which was made for indoors, then it was okay. But now what they did, they brought a new modem which runs outside. But we tested in different areas, and also we have these videos. If you can check on videos, in our videos we're gonna see the speed is a little bit different, you get me. But now we've been using the new 5G. What happened is, like, the speed we've been having here, it's different from the speed we are having the new one, because of we discovered what works and what doesn't work. So what I did, we mounted the 5G watt modem in the kitchen next to the window, because they say put it next to the window. It's been dropping the speed. The speed is on. Sometimes you can spend, if it's raining, it's a problem. And sometimes you get something which is supposed to give you at least 1,000 megabytes per second. It gives you even less than 2 megabytes, 5 megabytes, 10. Sometimes if it's fine, then it gives you somewhere around maybe 40, 50 megabytes per second. But now we're going to show the speed now we have, and we tell you how did we do that. So this is the thing. Look at the speed we have now compared to what we had. Look at that. Look at that. It has even dropped, because it's been running on 353 watt, but also this is still very good. So ever since we did the new trick, we never went below 200. So we've been running on 300 anyway. This is so amazing though. I wonder why it's now, like, it's even, I believe, like, it dropped. It was not there, it was more than 300. You can see now it went back. Yes, that's what I'm trying to say. Yes, it goes until to 321, 350. Yeah, but above 300. So we never, in the new trick, we did not get something like less than that. You can see that. So there are a couple of companies which test can do speed test. Let's see what we do here. Let's see, let's say start. You have to go using different websites. You're gonna see what you get. You can see this give us 333.36, and here it gives us 29. So the first one, you saw what it gave us. I remember you saw. So we don't want to repeat the same thing. Let's test another one. Let's see if this is not the same. We don't want to use the same company. We're gonna see. Yeah, this one is also good. It's a good platform to check your speed. Let's see what it's saying. See, it gives you the company. This is the company which gives me which gave me rain, is the one which gave us the 5G modem on the SIM card. Look what it says. You see the upload speed on this. You see here, it gives us 214. You can see, that's why it's good always to test using different stuff websites, because even when I use a phone, you see it gives me, the phone gives me 10 to 12 megabytes out of this. But now when I use the computer, it shows me this. This is the, we can see this guy gives us a different story, and this one gives us a different story, almost 100 plus megabytes, which are not read in the on this guy's website. So now what we're gonna do, we can go back and we try to, let me see, speed.net, no, we try this, it's different also. Let's see, we try to test using different websites and we see who's better. We're gonna see, yay, you can see, shaky, yeah, you can see all of them. What they have is the upload speed is approximately in the same range. They are 39 to 40. Also, this is not bad. You can see it goes clocks almost to 200 to 300. There's the one give us 215, that's something, this one 14, this one something we don't going to not going to take. We can test again, we see what they tell us. See if they give us less than 300, we would say we would not recommend that to be much of something reliable, because yeah, I believe we should not recommend this to be something you should use, because you can see what it gives us. This one, download speed, you can see, and other sites, they are in 300 and something. So I really can't recommend this. This is one of the things I'm not going to recommend. Let's go to something else. And so don't take your speed like on one test and you say, yeah, I'm running on this test. So you can really try to use different what websites and see what's going on. Oh, let's see this one. I've never used this one. This is the first time to use this. Can see also this one, it doesn't tell us the right thing, because it say, look, even less than 100. So to prove that, we can go to our first, the first one was this. Maybe the speed has dropped. If the speed has dropped, we will know. You can see there's no way that you can give me 50 and somebody give me 300, another and give me 300, another and give me 300. So the speed is not down. Also, this one is giving me 300, simply means those two, the first two, three, those three sites are not right. The one gives us less than 100, so 100 or 200, it's not right. So we're going with this one. So okay, what's the trick did we do? So what we did is like we mounted the modem inside the what, inside the house, which was wrong. It could maybe blocked by the walls or stuff, but it was on the kitchen next to the window. That I don't think is something which is advisable. So what we did, we took the router, we put it on top of the roof. But just know that you have to be staying in a safe area to do that. Maybe somebody can come and take it out when you're not at home or you went to work, stuff like that, because that router goes for almost 3,500, which you might not be able to replace that quickly. So what I'm saying is like, mount it outside. We mounted it up on the roof. If you're staying on the double store, it's gonna be good for you. It's easier. Maybe you can put it out on the wind outside the window, like the way you mount your satellite dish for DSTV, stuff like that. So I would say that's what you have to do. That's what we did. Ever since we've done that, we never had any problems like whereby the internet is off. Because if you mount it in the house, you don't want somebody to steal it or stuff like that. It's safe every time you close, and when you close your door, you know that it's safe. But now the problem, the conflict is sometimes it gets network, sometimes it doesn't get network. So it becomes a challenge. You can spend almost 1 hour. That means you don't have internet. And that's not the kind of life you want to live. So we want to test this. We want to see. We want to maybe download. Let me see. MP3 juice. I want us to download at least a video. Download YouTube MP4. We want us to download an MP4 here. We trying to do it live here. Let's try to see how long it's gonna take to download a video. We want something like maybe a music file. Oh no, like maybe let's see this how it's gonna be. I guess we can get this. It's not that. Let me skip that advert. And this is 9 minutes. I don't know how many megabytes we're gonna have. Let's copy this, and we stop that, and we go here. We're gonna see how faster it's gonna download this video. Because when I say start, yes, we got this video. So we're gonna download the HD. It's gonna be 164 megabytes. Full HD. Let's see. Let me hit enter. Keep this. You know, there's some things what they do before you download. We're not going to count that. Let's see what is gonna. So if it's downloading, it should show us here in this thing. So after that, so now we're gonna start downloading. Maybe we can start counting. We're gonna start counting. Count. Yes. Yeah. What's the final? Leave that. We download 164 megabytes. Look, you can see 164 megabytes. Wow, 4 seconds. Damn, this is done, guys. So crazy, so fast. This is done, man. So simply means, man, your if you have 5G, please take it out. You're gonna enjoy. I'm using the one for 1,000 rands a month, and I got it from Rain. It's a month to month contract, something which is very cheap if you are an internet user, because there's no limit on your data, though. So they're gonna give you unlimited data. I think, guys, I hope this helps, guys. If you're experiencing some problems, do put your 5G outside. Mount it outside. If you have the new modem, if you have the old modem, they I don't know, but the new modem, you should mount it outside. The old modem, maybe you should put it close to the window or get something to mount it if you can. But that old modem was not designed for outdoors, but the new one is the one which was designed for outdoors. So you might be paying your money and you see the internet slow, you hate Rain. No, it's not the issue. Put your modem outside where you put your dish, or up on the roof. Guys, I hope this helps. Thanks for watching, guys. Please don't forget to subscribe. If you have any question, please ask any question. See you in the next video.